Hi, fourth graders. This is Miss Vivatni, and today we will be comparing two fractions with different numerators and different denominators. Our goal is to be able to recognize when two fractions of each whole are greater than, less than, or equal to each other. Let's review what each number represents in a fraction. The top number is called the numerator. This represents the number of parts in a whole. The bottom number is called the denominator, which is the whole. We could also think of the denominator as the total parts of the whole. Let's begin by reviewing how to make common denominators. Something important to remember is that we cannot compare fractions easily unless the denominators are the same number. So, let's start out with the example 3/4 and 1/2. Take a moment to think about how these two fractions compare. Is 3/4 greater than, less than, or equal to 1/2? The first step is to draw a picture. The 3/4 circle is divided up into 4 sections, with 3 of the sections shaded in. Because 3/4 represents 3 parts of the whole. However, notice the circle labeled 1/2 is only divided into 2 parts, instead of 4 parts like the 3/4 circle. This tells us that the total number of pieces in the circle is not divided in the same way. Therefore, we need a common denominator. To make a common denominator in this case, we need to know how much larger 4 is than 2. We know that 2 times 2 equals 4. We need that information because we need to multiply 2 for both the numerator and the denominator in 1/2. So, let's write it out as 1/2 times 2 over 2 equals 2/4. Now, since 3/4 and 2/4 have the same denominator, we can compare them. Now we can easily see that 3/4 is greater than 2/4. Now, since we understand how to approach these problems, let's try a trickier example, 3/5 and 6/8. The first step to this problem is to draw a picture. The picture can give a good estimate about how they compare to each other. However, we can't tell for sure which one is greater than, less than, or equal to each other. This is when we find common denominators, just like we did in the last problem. Notice that the denominators are 5 and 8. We have to figure out a way to make the denominators equal. In order to do this, we can set up two fractions like we are going to add them. Then, we are going to multiply 3/5 by 8/8 and 6/8 by 5/5. By multiplying 8/8 and 5/5 to the sides with the opposite denominator, this creates a common denominator. You can also think about the denominator by saying, what is the common multiple for both numbers? In this case, it's 40. Then all you would have to do is multiply the numerator and the denominator of each original fraction by the other fraction's denominator. But remember, whatever you multiply on the top, you must do to the bottom, which is why we multiply 8/8 and 5/5 instead of 8 over 1 and 5 over 1. For our answer, we would get 24/40 is less than 30/40, which means 3/5 is less than 6/8. I hope this video helped you further understand the comparisons between two fractions with different numerators and different denominators.